Jesus. That got me.
Hello. Basically.
Hello.
Basically, we have to cut this one short today. But it's short and snappy. And it's what African parents do. Like, get on your nerves. All due respect to African parents, but to some extent. Okay, number one, laziness. Worst case scenario, in the sitting room, your mom's joining you for the first time in a year, and she's decided to put the remote right in front of her. No, she's there. Shagun is all the way in the kitchen. No, mommy wants to call Shagun to get something that is on hand, that is literally, basically in her hand. Shagun, come and get this remote for me. And then Shagun looks outside the window and he's like, mommy, it's there now. Shagun, if you don't get yourself here now, I will beat you. What's all this disrespect is? And then she starts doing the thing. And Shagun is cooking soup, making about everything all at once. But no, she has to go and she has to go and collect the remote. That's basically touching your mom's hand. Okay. I'm not saying everybody's mama does this, but a lot. Okay. Second one, kitchen. Your dad decides to cook for the first time in a million years, and now he thinks he's Daddy Oliver. He's standing beside the salt. Funke! You know you should be cooking here, but I'm just doing it because I'm a nice father. Come on, get this salt for me, lazy idiot. No, the salt is right beside you. But no, you want to go and call Funke, who is also doing her homework. So she doesn't feel just so serious. But no, you don't care. Do you, Daddy? Do you, Daddy Oliver? No, you're going to go and call Funke all the way to the kitchen to go and get salt that is beside you so you can season your disgusting tasting soup. Okay. Oh, that's fine. Should we move on to exams, Kendall's?
Yeah, okay. Basically, yeah, this is about exams. You see, when your parents, they just think, oh yeah, we are smart, we went to school, and they come out to you and they go, you see, back in the days when we used to go to school, we didn't have laptop, we didn't even want no computer. We have to uncandle, shine our eye, read it properly, like I will shine korokoro eye like this, read them. And you're like, hey daddy, but that's the whole point, because that was 1978. I don't even know. This is 2000 and Kimmy now, can you expect? Ah, you people think you can play smart on us, Abby? We've been there before you ever was, you know what's than us. What's the word they want to say? I know, I studied hard. I didn't even play. How can you tell me no play? You. What sort of lie is that?
You're
24/7, you have to read. How can you read in those 24/7? Psychologically, you really imagine now. Oh my dear, where is it? I can't do it. I think. You know, they start telling you the story of your life and you're like, no, fam.
Get comfy, daddy. You know? Yeah, it's going to be there for quite some time.
I'm telling you, they will spend 2 hours telling you how they actually had to do just one thing. And like,
thank you.
Seriously, I probably should have been telling us, but obviously, you can't say they should shut up now.
Of course not. They should want to
hit the girls. Hit the girls.
Hit the girls?
Yeah, the girls.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Your mommy and your daddy, they are like, they're as pristine as glass. Is glass even clean? No. So basically, they say how good they were as kids, how your mommy never used to go out with boys and your daddy never used to hang out with girls and play with girls. No, it's a lie. It's a big lie. No, I didn't do anything. I was sitting in my room all day reading these books. That's why I know good English. That's why you go and bang down all over the place. It's a lie. You know how to lie. You learned lying from when you was a young age. You're there saying that you didn't play with girls. Daddy, I'm on to you. Mommy, I'm on to you. You played with boys.
You know what the thing is, yeah? Okay, let us think. Especially we that we're about 18, 20, yeah? And then your parents are like our old 40 and shit. And they come out here and say, me, I didn't used to play with girls. I was so serious. Your mother will come and say, I was good. I've never opened my legs. When did you have me now? When is Papa Nakapako into you? Tell me. Me, I'm still here. I'm fine. I tell you.
Thank you. I understand this.
The last one, makeup. You know when your father just even see you using lip gloss? Even this earring I'm wearing. when you wear earring. This chain. where did you get the money to buy this bling bling? Hey, what is this now? Ah, you are wearing makeup. When you wear makeup, that means you want to buy a CA. But why can't I even use lip balm?
Thank you. Vaseline. If it's pink Vaseline, it's not even in this room. If it's pink Vaseline, what do you want?
You'll just see that how you screw it. So where do you think you're going to wear that Vaseline? So go and clean your mouth before you leave this house now. Isn't that rude?
That is very rude.
Isn't that rude? You cannot fair go share. They are too lazy. They can't even stand up on their own ass. They will tell you to even bring the water they want to drink. They are sitting down on the chair and saying, Shola, I'm going to be here.
Eternity, we still stormed up a cup. I could go on forever, because every single day there's a new one. So, kilo call me,
kilo versus. Please let us wait. We are waiting. Bye. Bye.
Wait 1 minute, Jessica, Temi, Ore, Shei, no, especially Jessica and Temi. I want to you. It's me and $ Nisa Thompson. Just what Yoruba can you speak?